Yes, good morning Onida. Today we are going to discuss about playing with numbers. Numbers means what we are using to represent number of things and how many things are there, how many pencils are there in your geometry box, how many books are there in your bag. Like that, for this purpose we are using, commonly you are using numbers to represent. Either I have 5 pencil, we have 10 notebooks in our bag, we have 6 subjects in our standard. Like that, we are using for different purpose, we are using numbers. Numbers is nothing but maths, maths is nothing but numbers. It mainly depend upon only numbers. We are using not only for study purpose, we are using for variety way, various types of numbers to play, to identify, to count, to add. For different purpose we are using numbers, and those numbers we are using to play for entertainment purpose. You are using, you are playing Ludo, is right? For Ludo also you are using how many numbers will come, either sometime 5, sometime 4 or 1, like that. For playing purpose also we are using numbers. For small kids also we are, they should remember the numbers and they should recognize the numbers. We are giving abacus instrument. Abacus instruments, they are easily find out the beats, how many beats are there. Mama, 2 beats, like that, 3, 4. For playing purpose also we are using numbers. The numbers are very important in our daily life. It's right, the numbers are very important. In that numbers also you learn already in 6th standard and 7th standard what are the different sets we are using in our number system. See, what are the different numbers we are using, different set of numbers we are using in our daily life. So the first is natural number, is right. The first set is natural number. The natural numbers is nothing but natural. See, natural, see, yeah, that object, the flower is a natural figure. It is a natural, that is not man-made. Rose is a man-made flower? No, that is not a man-made, that is natural. See here, the natural number is nothing but what numbers we are counting in our daily life. See, we are using 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, so on. Commonly in our daily life, we are using those numbers as common number. How many pencils are there? Mama, I have 2 pencil. 2 is a common number. 10 is a common number. So we called as, those numbers are called as natural numbers. The set of natural numbers are represented by capital letter N. Is it clear? The next set is whole number. The next set is whole number. Whole number is means that nothing special in that. What numbers we use in natural numbers, only we are adding 0. 0 with natural numbers are called as whole number. 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. And the set of natural numbers are represented by the letter W. Which letter we are using to represent set of whole numbers? W. Yes, right. The next is integers. Integers is nothing but both positive and negative numbers including 0. Both positive number, but in natural numbers and whole numbers we are using only positive numbers, whereas in integers we are using both positive numbers and also negative numbers including 0. Is right. And the set of natural numbers are represented by either I or Z. Either I or Z. See, these three types of group of numbers you heard in your previous standard. See, next class onwards you can use rational numbers, irrational numbers, those numbers also. Now that numbers are not necessary. For what purpose I revise, that means already what numbers we are using, natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, everything we are using here. so I revise all those things. See, under this lesson today we are going to discuss about your 8th portion. First lesson is playing with numbers. In the last previous class also you heard how to expand the numbers and how to express the numbers in terms of powers of 10. That is called as the general form. We are expand the numbers in terms of tens, base 10, base 5, like that you used. In the same way, you should expand, you elaborate the number in terms of 10. You should express on the basis of their place value. That is called as general form. What do we call for that? General form. Then how to express the numbers in the general form? How to express the numbers in general form? See here. 24 is the example here I am taking. 24, it's right. 24, how to express this 24 in the general form? See here, 24 means 24 is a two-digit number. 24 is a two-digit number. 4 is in the place of ones. 2 is the place of tens. 4 is the place of ones. 2 is the place of tens. You should write like that only. 2 into what is the place value of 2? Yes, the place value of 2 is 10. The place value of 2 is 10 plus. Here the first number is 4. What is the place value of 4 is 1. What is the place value of 4? That is 1. 2 into 10 plus 4 into 1 is the general form of 24. You can simplify that expansion. You'll get 24. See here. 2 into 10 is 20, 10 twos are 20 plus 4 ones are 4, 20 plus 4 is 24, 20 plus 4 is 24. And one more method is there to write the general form. You should raise the powers. Raise the powers. You start from 0. It's right. You should express in the form of exponential form. See here, 2 into 10 to the power of, what will be the power here? 1 plus 4 into 10 to the power of 0. 2, you should start to give the place values or powers from 1's place and you should start from 0, 1, 2, 3 like that, because we are expressing in terms of powers of 10. Their power is 0 means their value is 1. 10 to the power of 0 is 1, 2 to the power of 0 is 1, 5 to the power of 0 is 1. So their power is 1. 1 is nothing but a 1's place, a unique number. See, this is the general form of 24. See, look at the second number here, 346. Here 3 digit numbers we are using. How many numbers? 3 digit. You should express in the form of general. Give the powers now. You start from 0, 1, 2. 0, 1, 2. Now write it. 3 into 10 power 2 plus 4 into 10 power 1 plus 6 into 10 power 0. See ya, 0, 1, 2. And also you can expand in the form of their place value. See, 3 into 10 square is nothing but 10 is multiplied by 2 times. 10 is multiplied by 2 times. 10 tens are 100. 4 to the 10 to the power of 1 is 10 is only multiplied by 10 ones are 10. 10 into 4 is 40. 10 to the power of 0 value is 1. 4, 6 ones are 6. 146. And here 100 into 3 is 300. So it equal to 346. See, while writing in exams and all, you should write in terms of exponential form. Yes, right. That is the general form of this number. And the third example is 106. 106 here. How many digits are there in 106? Yes, 3-digit number. 106 is a 3-digit number. Yes, you should raise the powers now. 0, 1 and 2. Yes, tell me now. 1 into 10 power 2 plus 0 into 10 power 1 plus 6 into 10 power 0. See, you can write whole thing is 0 because 0 is multiplied by anything, the product is 0. You can write whole thing is nothing but 0. Otherwise, you write 0 into 10 power 1. See, the expansion or the general form of 106 is 1 into 10 power 2 plus 0 into 10 power 1 plus 6 into 10 power 0. Yes, is it clear? How to write the general form of a number. Next, we move on to how to write in decimal form. Decimal form means that is not 2.6, 3.6 like that. What numbers we are using, that is we express it in the form of decimals. Decimals means we express it in terms of powers of 10. Thus, decimal, that is not 2.4, 3.4, that like, it's right. See here, they given here the general form. You should write in decimal form. See here, 5 into 10, 7 into 1. 5 is in 10's place, 7 is in 1's place. 5 is in 10's place, 7 is in 1 place. So, 7 is in 1 place, 5 is in 10's place. So, the required number is 57. So, the required number is 57. Yes, is it clear? Now check. 6 is in 1000 place. 4 is in 10's place. 9 is in 1 place. Here there is no 100 place. There is no 100 place. 100 place nothing it will be means that is understood. The 100 place value is 0. So here the 1000 place is 6. 100 place they didn't mention here 100 place. Put 0 in the place of 100. Don't neglect that one 0. 100 place. Otherwise, your wrong number will be wrong. 10th place is 4. 1's place is 9. So, you read number 6049. 6049 is the required number. Is it clear? They didn't mention any place means in that place you have to put 10 further. And come to third example here. 9 into 100 plus 6 into 10 plus 1 into 1. 9 into 100. 100 place, 10's place and 1's place. So 100 place what it will be? 9. 10's place is 6 and 1's place is 1. Then how to read this number? 961. See, is it clear how to write in general form? or how to write in decimal form, vice versa. See, here they given in decimal form, you written in general form, and here they given generalized form, you written a decimal form. Yes, is it clear? Next we move on to alphanumerals and puzzles. The first only I told, this lesson name is playing with numbers. See, a puzzle is nothing but different types of puzzles are there. See, like Sudoku and all. For playing purpose, we are using that puzzles. See, here they given alphanumerals and puzzles. Alphanumerals and puzzles means it involving numbers and letters. It involving numbers and alphabets. Letters is nothing but alphabets, A to Z. By using that one, you have to play, you have to fun something. How? See here, they given some examples here. First one is 3, B and 7. 3, B and 7, they given here plus 7. See here, the operation is plus. Something is added to 3. Will get 7. The what number we have to add with 3 will get 7. That is called as a fun with puzzles. We don't know that one. What is the value of B? Just you should think, I'll give some work for your brain. And what number is added with 3 will get 7. What number? Yes, the number is 4. 4 plus 3 is 7. 4 plus 3 is 7. Yes, right? So, the value of B is 4. What is the value of B? 4. Some bright students, what they'll do? No, they should subtract these two numbers. 7 minus 3 is 4. So, the value is 4. That is as though another way to find out the value of B. Is right. Next comes to second example. Next comes to second example. 1 A, 1 A, the sum is 1 B and A. Is right. See here. Next, see one, you should do a multiplication here. You take a multiplication. 1, A, 1, A, 1, B and A. You should choose a numbers. See here, I'm taking first is A is equal to 1, B is equal to 2. A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 2. Let's check now, it satisfied or not. It satisfied or not. See here, 1 ones are 1, 1 ones are 1. 1 ones are 1, 1 ones are 1. 1, 2, 1. Yes, right. So here, the value of B is 2, the value of A is 1. Yes, the two values are satisfied. The value of A is 1, the value of B is 2. See, we got here 121. Only I substituted the value of A and B, we got 121. So here the value is 1, B value is 2. Yes, right. Next comes to third one here. Here I used plus operation. 1, 6, 2, A. So the sum is B, 1. So what is the value of A and B? And what number is added to A? We'll get the ones place number is 1. See here. Please remember, you observe carefully. Here the sum is 1 means that number becomes 11. Because 6 is the greatest number. Here 1 is the least number. In case the first number will be 1 means the sum it becomes either 1 or 21. The ones place number is 1. So what number will add to this 5 will get 11 or 21. Yes, A is equal to 5. A is equal to 5. See ya? 6 plus 5 is 11. 1 as carry, 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 plus 2 is 4. So what is the value of B? Yes, the value of B is 4. See, this is also, you should improve your thinking level. And also you are very curious to find out what is the value of A, what is the value of B, and what number we have to use. Means it improve your knowledge also. That is also, you are playing with number through these alphanumerals and puzzles. Yes, is it clear? The alphanumerals and puzzles means it involving a numeral and letters. Next, we move on to divisibility and reminders. Divisibility and reminders. Division, this word is very familiar for you. Division is nothing but the four things are very important. One is dividend, divisor, quotient, and reminder. What are those four factors? Dividend, divisor, quotient, and reminder. See, while doing a division, the dividend is greater than the divisor. But here, that division we started from 4th, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th also. Here what we have to do means, they'll give a specific divisor. You should find out what is the quotient and what is the reminder. See here, I'm taking an example. Find the quotient and reminder by 30. Here they given 44 and 36. These two numbers are dividend. You should divide these two numbers. The divisor is 13. Already they given. These two numbers are divided by 13. What reminder and what quotient will get? Let me check now. Here the first two number is 44. 44 is the dividend term, 13 is the divisor. 44 is a dividend, 13 is a divisor. From the second example, 36 is a dividend, again 13 is a divisor. What you have to find? We want to find out the quotient and reminder. You do common division. What we are following the step? The same steps we want to follow. Your 44 divided by 13. You know 13 ones a table? Yes, right. 13 twos are 26. 13 threes are 39. 13 fours are 52. But 52 is greater than 44. Better you have to choose 13 threes are 39. 13 threes are 39. That's right. Again, we can subtract from 4 minus 9. No. What you have to do? We want to take a borrow from the neighbor number. It becomes 14. 14 minus 9. 14 minus 9 is 5. 4, 3 minus 3 is 0. 3 minus 3 is 0. Here, what quotient we got here? The quotient is 3. And the reminder is 5. Reminder is 5. Is it clear? See, in this way, you have to find what is the quotient and what will get a reminder. Come to second example. Here also the divisor is 13 only.
36 divided by 13. 13 2s are 26. 13 3s are 39. 36 is less than 39. 36 is less than 39. So better you should choose 13 2s are 26. So 6 minus 6 is 0. 3 minus 2 is 1. Again you can't do because here 10 is dividend, 13 is divisor. We'll get a decimal number. So you write quotient is. Quotient is 2. Remainder is. Remainder is 10. Remainder is 10. So 3 is, see this way you have to find out a d remainder and quotient. You can use any number or any divisor. You have to find out remainder and quotient. See what we discussed today, the general form of a number and how to write a decimal form. See, the numbers are in decimal means you have to express in terms of powers of 10. The general decimal means the in terms of powers of 10 you should express in decimal form, and how to the numbers are expressed in terms of puzzles by using letters and numbers according to their operations, either plus or into or minus. And next is how to find out a remainder and a quotient by using a division process.